Right now, we are working to learn more information after investigators say a fifth grade girl at Forest Hills Elementary in Colleton County had to be flown to MUSC Hospital after a fight.
Brooke Griffin is at MUSC right now. Brooke, this is so difficult to hear. What have we learned so far about what happened?
So all we know right now is that that student from Forest Hills Elementary had to be airlifted right here to MUSC today to be treated for their injuries. The Colleton County Sheriff's Office is investigating an assault that occurred at that elementary school between two students. One of those students did need to receive medical treatment for their injuries. Now, we don't know the condition of that young student yet, but we know that they were airlifted here. Just like we said, they are very limited details. But the school district did tell us that they can't comment on the injuries of that student, but we do know that the other student involved has been suspended. Now, like we said, these are very limited details so far from the Colleton County Sheriff's Office. They said that's because this is an ongoing investigation. But as soon as they give us any details, then we will have those details for you right here on Live 5 News and on Live5News.com. At MUSC, I'm Brooke Griffin, Live 5 News.
Live 5 News starts now with breaking news.
This just in, breaking right now at 4, a fifth grader has been airlifted from Colleton County to the hospital after a fight in the classroom. The Colleton County School District posted on Facebook saying the elementary school student suffered injuries in a fight at Forest Hills Elementary. It says school administrators promptly secured the scene, ended the fight, and called emergency medical services to the school. The student taken to the hospital, then airlifted to MUSC for further treatment. No word on the girl's injuries at this hour. The post, though, from the Colleton County School District says an investigation has been opened. Now, we've reached out to the school district in Colleton County for more information. When we get that information, we'll bring it to you here on air and online at live5news.com.